Welcome to an example on finding the inverse of a 2x2 matrix using an inverse formula. If matrix A is defined using elements A, B, C, and D, then the inverse of matrix A is equal to 1 divided by the quantity A times D minus B times C times the matrix where we interchange the position of elements A and D, or these two elements here. And then for the elements B and C, they stay in the same position, but we change the sign. So once we find the inverse matrix, the original matrix A times A inverse is equal to A inverse times A, which would be equal to the identity matrix. And since we're talking about a 2x2 matrix, this would be the 2x2 identity. So let's look at our example. We want to find the inverse of matrix A. So A inverse, it's going to be equal to 1 divided by the quantity A times D, or negative 3 times 6, minus B times C, or negative 2 times 4. So we would have negative 3 times 6 is negative 18, minus negative 2 times 4, that's negative 8, times the matrix where we'll switch the positions of the elements negative 3 and 6. We'll put the 6 here and the negative 3 here. And for the other two elements, we'll change the sign, so this negative 2 becomes positive 2, this 4 becomes negative 4. So let's go ahead and simplify here. We have 1 divided by, this would be negative 18 plus 8, or negative 10. So we have 1 divided by negative 10, or negative 1 tenth, times the matrix with elements 6, 2, negative 4, negative 3. Let's go ahead and perform the scalar multiplication. So we'll have negative 1 tenth times 6, that's negative 6 tenths, or negative 3 fifths. And we'll have negative 1 tenth times 2, that's negative 2 tenths, or negative 1 fifth. Negative 1 tenth times negative 4 is positive 4 tenths, or 2 fifths. And then finally, negative 1 tenth times negative 3 is positive 3 tenths. So now that we've found the inverse of matrix A, this means that matrix A times A inverse would be equal to A inverse times A, which is equal to the identity matrix. In this case, would be a 2x2 identity matrix. Let's go ahead and check this product on the next slide. So again, now we'll check that A times A inverse is equal to a 2x2 identity matrix. So just to verify that we can perform this multiplication, we have a 2x2 matrix here, a 2x2 matrix here. So because the number of columns in the first matrix equals the number of rows in the second matrix, the multiplication is defined. And the number of rows in the first matrix, number of columns in the second matrix, give us the dimensions of our product. So our product is a 2x2 matrix. And now to find this product, we'll be using rows from the first matrix and columns from the second matrix. So to find the element in row 1, column 1, or this element here, which should be A sub 1, comma 1, we're going to multiply row 1 by column 1, which means we'll have negative 3 times negative 3 fifths, or negative 3 over 1 times negative 3 fifths, plus negative 2, or negative 2 over 1 times 2 fifths. So here we'll have, what, 9 fifths plus negative 4 fifths, which is equal to 5 fifths, or 1. Next we'll find the element in row 1, column 2. So we'll use row 1 from the first matrix, but now column 2 from the second matrix. So we'll have negative 3, or negative 3 over 1, times negative 1 fifth, plus negative 2 over 1, times 3 tenths. So here we'll have positive 3 fifths, plus, notice we have a common factor of 2 here, this simplifies the 1, this simplifies the 5. So we have plus, this would be negative 3 fifths, which is equal to 0. Now we'll find the element in row 2, column 1. So now we'll use row 2 from the first matrix and column 1 from the second matrix. Well, 4 times negative 3 fifths, or 4 over 1 times negative 3 fifths, plus 6, or 6 over 1 times 2 fifths. So we'll have negative 12 fifths plus 12 fifths, which is equal to 0. So far, so good. And now for the last element in row 2, column 2, we'll use row 2 from the first matrix and column 2 from the second matrix. We have 4 times negative 1 fifth, or 4 over 1 times negative 1 fifth, plus 6, or 6 over 1 times 3 tenths. So we have negative 4 fifths plus, again, this simplifies. We have a common factor of 2. There are 5 2s and 10 and 3 2s and 6. This would be 9 fifths, which is equal to 5 fifths, which is equal to 1. So we just verified the given matrix A times the inverse matrix that we just found is equal to a 2 by 2 identity matrix. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.